Welcome back to Ultraflux Workshop. In this sixth video, we are going to set up the probes on the pipe. We will use the V mode where the two probes are placed on a diameter plane, both of them on the same side of the pipe. Other mounting modes exist, but we will not detail them here. We recommend to place the probes on the horizontal plane. Avoid planes close to vertical because of the potential presence of deposits on the bottom of the pipe, or the accumulation of gas on the top. As well, do not place the probes on the pipe welding seams. It is important to identify a location with sufficient straight length to ensure a good accuracy. After a perturbation, leave a minimum distance of 10 times the pipe diameter. Increase this distance to a minimum of 30 times the pipe diameter if the perturbation is a pump or a divergent. Make sure a minimum of 5 times the pipe diameter is available after the probes. Those values we just gave here apply for liquid applications using the V mode. Then make sure the pipe surface is clean without dust. The painting must be in good condition and well attached on the pipe, without blisters. If it is peeling off, remove it with a brush or a scraper, otherwise the air gap under the paint will stop the ultrasounds. The 1586 probes are mounted in a rail. The probe distance is measured between the two dots on the side of the probes using the integrated ruler. The elastic strap has to be wrapped around the pipe to install this support. The 1515 and 1599 probes have individual supports. If the probe distance is less than 350 mm, you should assemble them together. If not, align them properly and make sure the connectors for the cables are on the outside. Those supports are easy to set up on magnetic pipes thanks to their magnets. Be careful, those magnets are powerful. On non-magnetic pipes, use the provided nylon straps. The probe distance is measured between the two vertical lines on the side of the probes using the integrated ruler or measure tape. Let's place the probes on the pipe. First, adjust the probe distance. Then, screw the knobs to lift up the two probes. Apply some coupling gel on the probe surfaces. Place the kit on the pipe and hold it firmly. Wrap the elastic strap around the pipe and block it with the two slots in the rail. Tighten it well. Then completely unscrew the knobs to lift down the probes. They should now be in contact with the pipe. Check and adjust if needed the probe distance. Your flow meter and the probes are now ready. In the next and final video, we will read the measurement and do some first diagnostics.